In this video, I'll be showing you how to make a sitemap and plan for your website. I recently combined content from my portfolio sites, but I haven't taken the time to redesign the experience of it yet. So I'll be taking you along this journey with me as I redesign my own portfolio website, and hopefully it will help you design yours either for the first time or maybe redesign. Step one is to ask yourself, what are the goals for your website? This will influence the experience of your website to help you achieve those goals. Using my website as an example, one of the goals is to hire me. This means I'll have to create a portfolio section and a contact page. Another goal is for someone to learn more about me, my past experience, projects, and links to things I've worked on. There's also a shop where I will be adding design resources for other designers to purchase. Also a blog that I'll continually update with new work and videos, and a landing page to sign up for an email newsletter so people can keep in touch with the projects that I work on and find out ways to work with me. Dive into the first goal, which is to hire me. This dictates that we'll need a couple of pages to help support this goal, one of the most important ones being a contact page. We'll also need a portfolio section so people can see what my work looks like, and maybe an about or resume type page that gives a summary of my experience and links to specific projects. Now, a contact page is pretty vague, so let's break that down. That means we'll need a contact form, but we should also talk a little bit about how someone can work with us. This way, we'll get targeted leads rather than wasting our time with people that won't be a good fit to work with us. For the portfolio section, I already know that I'll want to include case studies or photos of work from the last three companies I've worked with, and this will make up the design section of my portfolio. But I also want to include some photography as well. A tip for doing your website is to do this same mind mapping exercise so that you'll discover exactly what content and pages you'll need to create to achieve the goals for your website. Now, let's use this information to create the sitemap. We'll start with the homepage, and for this, I've already started to think about how I want to structure this. I would like the homepage of my site to be more of that about section, so maybe it's a large paragraph of text that's talking about who I am, what I do, and then links to specific things that will help navigate to other parts of the website. There's also the contact page and the portfolio divided up into design and photography. Even though these will be individual pages on the website, I still want to explicitly call them out on that about page, which will be the home page. And I'll also want to include the blog as well. Depending on how complicated your website is, you may notice that you'll have multiple subpages within pages. For this site, I'll only have three levels: the home page, then portfolio, about, contact, and blog, and photography and design, which would go within portfolio. This is an introduction to site mapping and how to plan out your website. I hope it kind of gave you some tips and ideas for how to put together your site and really focus on those goals. This is part one of the series where I redesign my portfolio site. Next up is gathering design inspiration and creating mood boards to set up the look and feel that you want to create for your website. After that, I'll dive into wireframing the website, then I'll start the UI design process for the website, and the final step is to build it. For now, I'm using Squarespace, so I'll be taking my designs and using that to customize the theme. If you're interested in seeing the rest of my design process for a website, be sure to subscribe and stay tuned for those videos in the future. If you found this video helpful, give it a like and also leave a comment. Tell me more about your process for designing a website. Do you do anything different? Did this help give you any ideas? Let me know by leaving a comment below.